Hello, this is Bern, and if you want to find out what's the most important thing that needs to happen inside a man for him to commit to you, you are in luck, because I'm about to reveal that on my episode today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetv.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women like you, how you can attract the kind of quality man you want as a result of being your most alive and feminine version of yourself, and without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or crazy and silly techniques. Now, today, I'm going to talk to you about what needs to happen inside a man's heart for him to commit to you. Here is the thing, if what you want is a deep relationship and you've determined that you want long-term marriage, children, or something similar to that, and you've been connecting with men who can't commit, here's the fundamental shift that needs to happen inside his head and heart combined for him to commit to you. He needs to understand, he needs to realize, he needs to recognize, he needs to see, feel that losing you is more painful and more uncomfortable than what he has to do to commit to you. Think about it. For him to commit to you, who in his mind basically saying he's gonna be one woman for the rest of my life, right? For that, he needs to know that the sacrifice that he's stepping into, the loss, if you wanna call it, of certain levels of freedom is worth, I mean, he's getting something that's worth more than that. Now, here's a caveat. Not every man is gonna feel that way. And you could be Wonder Woman and have all the qualities and attributes. Some men will never see it that way. Some men will always feel, and some women too. It's not just about men, but since I'm talking to women, so I'll say this to you. Some guys will never get to the space where they feel, okay, I'm willing to sacrifice connecting with more women or having sex with somebody that's not just one person for the wealth of connection, the depth, the excitement, the passion, being seen at the deepest level. Some guys don't get it that way. And if you're spending time with guys who don't fundamentally have that understanding that that's something meaningful in their lives, you really are wasting your time. Let me give you an analogy to tell you how this works and also how do you get there, right? Because, okay, now you understand that for a guy to commit to you, he needs to know that losing you is more painful than not losing you. But how the hell do you move forward? Well, here's the thing. I only have time in this video to give you three of those specific actions or mindsets or shifts you can make to get closer to that. If you want to learn more about that, at the end I'll share a link where you can actually go through a full masterclass that goes much more in depth. But for right now, let's go with this. Imagine that you're a realtor and that you're choosing who you're going to spend your time connecting with and prospecting to get clients. Are you going to put your time and energy into human beings who are renting houses and have no desire to purchase a home and have no credit history? Or are you going to put your time and energy on those human beings who've actually become hungry to own a home? That's their dream, that's their passion. They've done some of the work, they have good credit history, and they're ready to take the next step. If I were you and I were a realtor, I would spend 100% of my freaking time on guys and women who want to already purchase a house versus convincing someone that buying a house is a good thing to do. Do you see that? Now, it's not to say that some people who are renting and don't have any desire to buy a house, maybe they'll go into a big, bright, beautiful house and they'll say, wow, I should buy a house. Now, that happens in love as well. There's guys who have no desire, no commitment to go deeper, no sense of responsibility, and the inkling that something more meaningful is better than something just more pleasurable, right? And they could actually become something hits them over the head and now they convert into relationship-ism, right? But why the fuck would you spend your time with guys like that? My thing to you, sister, is if you want to get this thing going, is that you commit to spending and investing your time with human beings who want to purchase a house, meaning guys who already understand that sacrifice in life is a good thing, that responsibility in life is something that creates meaning, and that a relationship, however painful and however many things you have to leave on the table to pursue, is something that creates a lot more excitement long-term and a lot more fulfillment long-term. So that's the first thing, okay? Spend and invest your time on guys who already know that relationships are awesome and that they want a long-term relationship, not that you have to convince them that a long-term relationship might be a good thing for them, right? Second thing is make a strong commitment to being your most radiant self. So what does that mean? For you to naturally be your most radiant self, that includes, or you have to figure out what you want, you have to step into it in life, you have to be willing to be self-expressed, you have to be willing to love yourself and your body and your curves or lack thereof as they are today. You have to be willing to step into self-worth. You have to be willing to do a bunch of things that are not necessarily the most comfortable, but the combination of those things, if you live into your passions, if you love yourself, not from a conceited place, but from a place of true worth, if you step into service of something greater than yourself, if you do those things, then the natural, and if you remember to smile, the natural result of that is you will be more radiant, meaning you will be more attractive to the right guy. Now, that doesn't mean that you will, again, you'll convert a guy who doesn't want to get married into now getting married. But if you're being that way, here's the thing that will happen for you. You will have more options. More men will see you from a distance. More guys will want to ask for your number. More guys will want to take you on dates. More guys will want to take you on second, third, fourth, fifth dates and become exclusive with you if you are committing to your own radiance and not wasting time with guys who can't just bring it. And the last thing that you have to do, and it's something hard, because I think a lot of people say this thing, be more of you. But that's the thing. You need to understand fundamentally who you are and express more of that for two reasons. Because you want to attract the right guy who's attracted to the real you, and you want to repel instantly the guy who's not attracted to the real you. Now, that's not to say that if you have some big flaky faults that you should just say, well, that's who I am. No, you can change those things. But if you're stepping into a relationship by expressing who you are, by being authentic. If you hate dancing, saying, I hate dancing. If you love dancing, say, I love dancing. If you love movies, say, movies are my passion. If you never want to stay inside and you always want to be outside, then say, I'm looking for a guy who's outside 99% of the time. I hate being inside. If you're more like that, instead of saying, well, do you like to be inside? Yeah, sometimes. And the answer is no. Or do you like, let's say you like dancing and the guy doesn't, say, well, dancing is cool sometimes. If that's your passion, be more upfront about it so that more quickly, more easily, the wrong guy for you can say, it's not a mismatch, versus trying to become this vanilla mixed version of you that doesn't really hit home for anyone. Be hated or loved, but not in between. So there you have it. Three specific things that you can do. Not waste time with men who don't have that vision. Commit to your own radiance, doing whatever it takes to get there. And three, being more of you, more self-expressed, and more honest about what you love and what you hate, instead of trying to appease him or trying to be more likable or trying to be more vanilla. Be black and white and chocolate chip, but don't be vanilla, is my thing. Now, if you find this is helpful, meaningful, and insightful to you, my dear, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Number one is on the description of this video, I've created, on the first line on the description of this video, I've created a way for you to go way deeper onto these concepts and understand what it really takes to find your ideal soulmate now. All you have to do is click on that link, enter your name and email, and you'll start watching that free masterclass right away. Aside from that, if you enjoy this video, click like or thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and click on the little bell if you want to be notified of new episodes. Last but not least, if you ever want to get coached, if you want assistance, if you want hand-holding, second link on the description of this video will allow you to apply to connect with me. Thank you so much for showing up. Thank you so much for listening to this. Thank you so much for allowing me into your heart, into your home, into your cell phone, and for committing to not staying with what you have. What you have is not what you want. Huge hug to you.